Like we did for epithelial tissue, we're going to go through each of the connective tissues and talk about the structure, location, and function. Be sure you are able to identify the tissue when you see it. Okay, so recall that connective tissue is further subcategorized into four categories: connective tissue proper, cartilage, bone, and blood. On this page, we're going to look at connective tissue proper. Now, connective tissue proper is even further subdivided into loose and dense. The first three that we talk about are the loose connective tissues. Those are areolar connective tissue, reticular connective tissue, and adipose connective tissue. The other three, the dense connective tissues, are dense regular connective tissue, dense irregular connective tissue, and elastic connective tissue. The difference between the two subcategories is that loose connective tissue has more ground substance and fewer fibers. Dense connective tissue has less ground substance and more fibers. Okay? So let's get started examining each of these connective tissues. Areolar connective tissue is a very loose type of connective tissue. It provides wrapping around organs. It surrounds all the blood vessels just sort of to keep them in place. When you're dissecting and open up a body cavity, you'll see a lot of areolar connective tissue, and it appears to be sort of like thin strings of spider web-like material. It's very easy to ignore and just pull out of the way because you're trying to look at underlying structures and organs. But because of its spacious and loose appearance, it's able to hold water inside of it as well. So overall, it provides wrapping around organs. Reticular connective tissue is also one of my favorite tissues because it's very pretty and I think it looks like Japanese cherry blossoms. So I enjoy looking at this type of tissue. But because of the reticular fibers within this type of connective tissue, it provides a nice framework for an internal structure, like scaffolding. And we find this type of tissue in lymph nodes, the spleen, and bone marrow. These are locations where there needs to be a framework inside of the organ so that other cells and processes can happen. The last type of loose connective tissue proper that we'll talk about is adipose connective tissue. Adipose connective tissue is all of the fat tissue in our bodies. Adipocytes are large cells that store a lipid droplet. We find adipose tissue in many locations of the body. The hypodermis, which is located deep to the dermis, is made up of adipose connective tissue. Breast tissue, much of it is adipose connective tissue. Our eyeballs sit in a pocket of fat tissue. Fat tissue also surrounds our organs. We have visceral adipose connective tissue. So it provides insulation, cushion, and a reservoir for energy storage. Adipose tissue i.e. the lipid within the cell, can be used as an energy source. The first of the dense connective tissues that we'll talk about is dense regular connective tissue. That word regular is significant because another type of dense connective tissue is dense irregular connective tissue. And that word regular means that the fibers are arranged in a very predictable and parallel pattern. If you look at the tissue, the pattern of the collagen is a wavy parallel pattern. That means that those collagen fibers are arranged along a specific plane. And because of that, this overall tissue can resist tension, so pulling forces in a single plane. And that's exactly what we need in tendons and ligaments. Tendons connect muscle to bone, and ligaments connect bone to bone. And so those structures need to be able to resist tension in very specific and predictable planes. When we talk about dense irregular connective tissue next, we'll see that that tissue resists tension in many directions. So dense regular connective tissue is found, as I indicated, in tendons and ligaments. It's comprised of fibrocytes and fibroblasts, so cells that produce collagen fibers, arranged within very predictable and parallel bundles of collagen. Dense irregular connective tissue is characterized by collagen bundles that are randomly positioned throughout the tissue. Instead of those collagen bundles being arranged in a parallel and predictable pattern, these collagen fibers are going every which way, up, down, side to side, three-dimensionally in another direction, so that overall this tissue can resist pulling forces in every single direction possible, which is great because in the dermis, that's what you need. We find this tissue in the dermis of our skin. It's able to resist tension in many directions. The last of the connective tissue proper category is elastic connective tissue. Now, heads up, there's also an elastic cartilage. So make a mental note that there are two types of tissues that begin with the word elastic. This is elastic connective tissue. If you look at this tissue, you can see that there are elastic fibers arranged in a squiggly but parallel pattern. That's because this tissue is found in the wall of large arteries and large airways, bronchi. Those structures need to be able to stretch and recoil. That concludes our discussion on connective tissue proper. On the next page, we're going to talk about cartilage.